What's up, everybody? Today, we're going to expose new construction houses, noob versus pro style. Let's go check them out. New construction is something that's always super energizing and exciting. When you walk into a new construction house, you love it. You fall in love right away. How could you not? Especially when you compare to like resale homes. But what is it that you don't know? Let's look. So a noob walks into a house like this and says, oh my gosh, there's stones on the wall, there's fancy paint, fancy railings, this is so beautiful, look at how they designed this, this is amazing, and this is the price, I want in right now. Well, a pro looks at this house and says, ooh, nice flooring, that's a $20,000 upgrade. Custom cabinet color, upgrade. Fancy pendant lights with broken light bulb, upgrade. Backsplash, upgrade. Stove, upgrade. Countertop, upgrade. Stone veneer, extra can lights. Ceiling speakers, upgrade, upgrade. Upgrade. Fancy flower wallpaper? Upgrade. Light fixture with another missing bulb? Upgrade. Patterned Berber carpet? Upgrade. Porcelain tile with overspray paint under your vanity? Upgrade. Tiling in your downstairs shower? Glass door? Upgrades. Contrasting paint color? You better get used to all white unless you want to pay for an upgrade there too. Window coverings? Yeah, you get some drapes if you pay for the upgrade. Don't expect anything on your actual windows, but you know what? That's okay because right outside this window here, you got the best looking vehicle you could ever ask for. Come on, meet Kevin, folks, meet Kevin. Tiling, countertop, sink itself. You know what, cabinet itself, upper cabinet itself, upper cabinets over here. Upgrade, 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 upgrade. Mosaic wall tile, upgraded tub, upgraded textured porcelain tile on the floor, Corvette style, upgrade, upgrade, upgrade. Oh, ants on your toilet? That's an upgrade too. The ants must have killed the spider. So this is usually where the noobs go, dang it, I'm stuck with carpet, linoleum, and white square tiles, but I still like the house, and I mean, maybe I can collect some money for upgrades, and then it'll all be done. And you know what? This is where the pro comes in and says, yeah, Kevin, that's exactly right. The house like this is done. I mean, look around. Even if you get just carpet, linoleum, and you buy something like first phase new construction, and you get in early, there are some benefits to buying new construction. You don't have to deal with contractors, coordinating all the junk that you have to deal with, following up, and you get some pretty sweet warranties as well. But let's talk a little bit more about some other things you might not know about. So as I walk through this butler's pantry, the pro investor says, there's a little bit of risk to new construction in terms of value and my net worth. Where the new buyer says, come on, real estate doesn't go down in value. We should just be able to buy this property and all be fine and cheery. Well, new construction comes with extra costs. And a lot of it might not be realized right up front. Mostly, when you buy new construction, you're generally paying a little bit above market value for the benefit of it being new and the benefit of having builder warranties. So don't kid yourself, you're paying for those warranties. Usually, it's very difficult for people to resell a new construction home and break even anytime within 2 years after buying a new construction property. Whereas if somebody bought a resale property, much like buying a used car, and they did a little bit of cosmetic renovation to it, they can usually end up with a lot more real value, nothing fake. A noob looks at new construction and says, sweet, new neighbors, new investors, new parks, new houses, everything's new, this is great. An experienced investor looks at new construction and says, well, wait a minute, this means the neighborhood is a relatively unknown factor. That is, how are marketing considerations in the neighborhood? What are days on the market for reselling a property or renting a property? How could this possibly affect my net worth in the future as the area starts becoming what it will be? That is the neighborhood. Is it going to decay? Who's moving into it? What is the median income of the buyers living in the neighborhood? All of these things are unknown factors that could affect an investor's net worth, even if the region itself is overall positive. Things to keep in mind when investing in real estate. This is why investors prefer the sizzle hot neighborhoods. Let's talk. Safety is always a big concern when it comes to investing. And when investors select sizzle hot neighborhoods that have low days on the market times for renting or for sale, they can be relatively safe investments. Obviously, any investment comes with risk, but investors generally like safety when they can get it. That's why sizzle hot neighborhoods that have a proven reputation sell and rent fast. New construction, you don't have that. Another noob mistake that noobs make is when they see new construction, they just walk right into the model homes. Well, the pro knows that that immediately waives the buyer's right to having an agent represent them. See, here's how this works. New construction builders are obligated to cooperate with agents because they want to advertise their houses in what's known as the multiple listing service so that they show up on realtor.com and websites like Zillow. Well, the problem with that is if you don't have representation, even though it doesn't cost you anything, yeah, the builder's getting a little bit more profit, but you don't have an advisor that's able to help you walk through and navigate the maze that can be new construction home purchasing, and you don't have that second opinion on, hey, the builder's doing this, is this normal? Now, another newbie thing that people say is, they don't build houses like they used to. And you know what? Those noobs are right. Houses are built way better than they used to be built. Look, I hear things all the time like, but they used to build houses with redwood and they were of much higher quality and all this junk. But here's the thing. We live in California, and in California, we have earthquakes. At least I live in California. And the construction standards today are so much better. The type of hardware that's installed, the preventions for health and safety issues in terms of mold or fire risk with fire sprinklers, and the mitigation of energy loss throughout houses is so much better today than it ever was in the past. Any contractor, any builder, that knows what 1950s, 1920s houses are like, knows that a 2018, 2019 house is built way better than anything historical. You know, another good one the newbies tell me is, new construction, I don't have to worry about termites. Well, let me tell you something. New construction homes are exposed to the environment for 6 to 12 months at any given time. New construction homes are also generally built with dug fir, which is really tasty for termites. This is where that saying comes from, they don't build them like they used to. This is where the pros say, hey, well, some of these 1940s homes were built with redwood, and houses that were built with redwood, kind of disgusting for termites. Something to know. See, another thing newbie buyers don't know, and the other reason why you want an agent when you go into new construction homes is, well, the final walkthrough is really important, and so is the actual building process. Think about it, the best time to inspect a new construction house is before the drywall's up, because that's when you can see the plumbing, electrical, and the sewer, and the expensive things. It's the best time to check it out. Who cares about testing the outlets on the outside of the drywall? That stuff's pretty inexpensive. Very difficult to schedule your inspection after the drywall's up and actually expect good results. And don't kid yourself, this is actually another broken light bulb. But that's not really what I wanted to say. What I actually wanted to say is, don't kid yourself. The builders will always tell you, you need to close, we're under deadlines, we're gonna charge you more fees if you don't close on time. They do that because really, when you go through in your inspections and you start making your requests to the builders that, please fix this before I close escrow and things like that, they threaten you to close as soon as possible because the builder's got a lot of debt outstanding. Every house that sells, they can pay off a portion of that debt and release new funding so they can continue to build new homes. So they're really, really incentivized to help finish the things that need to be finished on your house before escrow closes. The pro knows if you want the builder to do something, you get it done before escrow closes. The noob says, I got a 1-year warranty for fit and finish. They'll take care of me, I'm sure of that. Now here's the thing, I don't wanna just give you all the dirty laundry about new construction homes. New construction homes can be great, and it's a really exciting process to buy a new construction house and get something that you don't have to renovate. They can be great for first-time homebuyers because you don't have to deal with, as I always recommend, like in my real estate investing course, how to buy wedge deals, that is buying them with disparity for under market value, building in equity so you're safer and you can prevent issues like foreclosure or short sales or some of those dramatic and crazy things. But all things being equal, new construction homes can be a very fun process and a great opportunity. Best recommendation that the pro knows is get in first phase. A noob for new construction usually comes in and says, well, I'm gonna negotiate the price. A pro knows that the builder is not incentivized at all to negotiate with you on price. There are different incentives. Let's talk about that. The reason the builder's not interested in negotiating with you on price is it sets a bad precedent to all the people that are in escrow. And the last thing the builder wants is more cancellations, because cancellations means the bank's tightening their belt and they're not giving any more money for the builder to continue doing their work. Banks don't like cancellations. Nobody likes cancellations. But the pro knows, also fake coffee, the pro knows that the way to negotiate with a builder is negotiating options and builder upgrades. Things like this fancy flooring and all the upgrades we talked about before, that's where the builder is most incentivized, because guess where it doesn't show up? It doesn't show up on the public record. Instead, builder can show, look, we continue to have increasing sales prices, makes appraisals very easy, makes the banking process for the builder very easy, the banking process for future buyers very easy, and overall a less stressful situation. So you have to know, as I always talk about in my real estate investing course, when you are negotiating, what is the other party's motivation? For the builder, don't touch price, touch the other intangibles. Now, right now we are inside a 400 square foot studio that is detached from the main house we were just in above that house's garage. And a pro investor looks at this and says, yes, let the builder build this addition because the builder is going to get it done with scale. That is, they're building hundreds of these additional units and they can use the same plans. If I go to retrofit, remodel, build a guest unit, I'll probably end up spending twice as much as the builder spent. So here is a case of an upgrade where the pro says, I'm buying it. And the noob looks and goes, oh, 100 grand just to have 400 square feet above the garage? Come on, man. Looks like this little unit would rent for about $1,400 a month. Not bad for 400 square feet. Oh yeah, and the other thing is, don't forget to qualify the HOA, if there is a homeowners association, that they're going to allow you not only to rent the property out, but make sure you check out that what your plans are actually fit with kind of what you're looking for. So that is, if you think the builder says they're gonna be adding a new park, does the HOA have rules for once that park is built, we're going to assess you higher fees? It's usually all in what's called the public report that the builder publishes, but nobody ever reads. Last thing is, the pro investor knows the builder's going to push the new construction preferred lender onto them. And you know what? They might end up having the best deal. It is what it is. And unfortunately, your reputable lender that's in your circle, the one that you've used in the past, probably realizes that if you're going into new construction, the new construction lender wins 9 out of 10 times on pricing. But that doesn't mean you shouldn't shop them. The noob goes in and says, builder lender, they're giving me a credit. I'm in. Doesn't even shop around. Make sure to get what's called your loan estimate. That's an official term now. It used to be called a good faith estimate. Check that. Shop your lenders and get the best pricing. The other thing you don't find out about new construction is once you move in, you realize who has the loud barking dogs. Resale, you can figure this out beforehand. I purposely like to go to old houses when I'm looking at buying them. I open all the gates and I slam them at like different times of the day. Wake them up. Last, the pro investor knows to go to a builder with a great reputation, one for quality and one for following up with complaints or problems and helping solve them. Because a company isn't made by their initial successes, it's made by how they handle failures or mistakes and how they handle customer service. If you recognize this builder, I support them. I won't mention them because I did mention some negative things here about new construction in general. But hey, new construction overall, buy the real estate course and learn more.